YouTube, what's good? So I looked over my most watched video and I noticed that a lot of people were having problems with connecting their devices with MPC Beats and saying they can't get it to work. So I want to possibly make a video and show you how we could possibly troubleshoot those things and get your devices to work with MPC Beats so you can use it. I know some people said they were pressing buttons, they don't hear sound coming out, they can't get it to work, nothing's going on. So I just want to go over a few things to help you guys maybe understand a little bit better. Real quick, MIDI stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, and it's basically just the way that devices talk to each other. It's like their language. Most music devices, especially built recently, especially like in the last 20 years, like they're all like mostly MIDI capable, and it'll say if it isn't, but most likely if you have a controller that you bought recently, it is MIDI compatible. So if a program uses MIDI, you can use it with that program. It does not matter what company makes the program, what company makes the device, you can use whatever you want, as long as it's MIDI capable, and most things are, so that's one thing. A lot of people ask me, well, can I use this with MPC Beats? Can I use that with MIDI? Yes, if it has MIDI, yes, 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 yes. The answer is yes. So, you know, I have a MPK Mini 3, as you can see, and we're gonna try to figure this out for y'all today, all right? First things first, I know someone said they were pressing the pads and nothing was happening, right? And that happened to me the other day. And you know what I did? I'm gonna show you. I did this, I took this out, and then connected it right back and started working again. I don't know, just make sure you tried that first before we do anything, okay? And then I saw that on the app and Cree video too, so that definitely helps. So what I wanna do is possibly get this in focus so we can see. So what I want you to do is look at the top right of the program. So to know if your MIDI is connected, let's see, I'm pressing the keyboard right there. You see it show up on the screen. See that light blinking, top right corner? That's how you know the information is being sent back and forth, all right? So you should be good money. Now, problem that a lot of people have is, for some reason, MPC Beats, see I'm pressing pad one, A1, but pad two and MPC Beats is being triggered. And then I press two and one is being triggered. And it's like, why is that happening? All right, so that's what we want to fix because it's annoying, right? So that's what we're gonna do, all right? And I learned this from a Matthew Stratton video. I'm gonna link it his too because he has like tons of videos on MPC stuff because he probably actually uses this. I don't use this a lot, but I use it sometimes. But make sure you have like, actually no, I'm bugging. Click on this right here. And we'll go to factory. And you want to pick your template. So mine is the Akai. I don't know if you can see it. Might not be able to see it, but it's Akai Mini 3. Then I pick it. And that's a template for this controller. So now you see when I press A1, that pad is going 2 and vice versa. It goes all the way up, right? And that's what's supposed to happen. And then this is already set. Boom. All right. So everything works because we just used the template. I see how it says Akai MPK Mini 3 right here, because that we're supposed to be using. So what you need to do, whatever the name is of your device, you need to click there and you need to find your maker and find the device that you have. Now, let's say your device isn't up there, right? Because that's very possible. This is what we're gonna do. Let's do this, you know, because I don't have another controller here, but I do have my machine. So we're gonna unhook this. All right, so now we're gonna hook this up. And it's doing the same thing, right? It's not. All right, everything's wrong. Yeah, that's not right. So what we need to do is make our own. So just let's say you don't have the MPK Mini 3, you have a different device. You can't find a template for it up there. That's what we're gonna do. First, we're gonna go to the preferences. All right, go to MIDI. make sure control is on, right? All right, it's on and we're good. And this is what I learned from the Matthew Stratton video as well. Click here, we're gonna do a new MIDI map, right? And so now we're going to click learn. We're just gonna make our own template. So we're gonna click on the first pad, hit that, boom, hit that, boom, hit that, boom, hit that. And then we're just gonna do this for all the pads. Okay, and then let's say for the, I wanna control these things, so I'm gonna click that, use his knobs. Click this knob, that one, that knob. That one for this knob, this one for this knob, that one for that knob, that one for that knob, right? And we'll just do that for now and learn. So now when I press the first pad, boom, trigger, boom, 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 boom. So that is how you can enable your stuff, whatever you're using. If you don't have a template, make your own and you can MIDI learn it that way, okay? So that should help you. And then you see these, yep. The knobs, you see it turning. Boom. So that way you can use the knobs on whatever controller you have, whatever you device you have, should not matter. You should be able to use anything with whatever you have, all right? Now, if you have any questions, if you still have problems, leave them in the comments. I'm trying to think of what else could possibly be the problem, but you should be good with that, all right? So hopefully that helped you guys out, leads you in the right direction. I'm gonna leave Matthew Stratton's video link just so you can see his as well, because he goes really in depth with a lot of things as well for MPC. And I'll catch you on the next video, all right? Peace.